Another rough day for the stock market. Stocks falling again amid fears of the coronavirus. This leaves Wall Street with its worst week since October of 2008. So what will the coronavirus mean for the future of stocks and your finances? We're joined now by Lyle Wolberg, a senior financial life advisor at Talamis, and we thank you for joining us today.
Glad to be here.
So we got to really kind of hit this right from the start here to say, look, with anything, you want to say, do not panic. And when people see things like headlines like that, they do tend to panic. What do you tell them?
This market is full of fear right now. And there's good reasons. We don't have the right data. I don't think the data coming out of China is reliable. I couldn't tell you today whether the market's overvalued or undervalued. And until we know that, don't act in fear.
We know that the stock market has been very healthy in the last few years. And of course, the president has had so much of his campaign coming into the last 6 months saying, look at the economy. And so there is a political, you know, function here when people are arguing on both sides. But we take that away and we say, what should an investor, someone who's watching right now, what should they be doing amid these falls?
Well, maybe this market reaction, which, like you said, is one of the worst since 2008, is a kick in the pants to start planning and doing it earlier. Because most people who have done the right planning have put aside cash that they know that they're going to need in the next 12 to 24 months, and they're not going to be selling into weakness like we're seeing today. So if you haven't done the planning, go out and find an advisor, talk to them, and sit down and think about what do you need in the near term so that that money's not sitting in the stock market.
Because regardless of what happens, if you are planning ahead and you're not working from a place of fear, you're going to be in a better place tomorrow than you were today. And that is, of course, the hope. In the meantime, when you take a look at walking into the next week and the next few days, if this coronavirus thing doesn't subside, we hope it does, what do you think will happen as we move forward? I know you don't have a crystal ball, but we can expect to hear more dips.
Yeah, I think you're looking for opportunities to get in and buy once we get some better data, once we understand what the impact to the gross domestic product will be, to the economy, to the world as a whole. So you want to be ready to either change your allocation to more aggressive if you can afford to do that. But I think we need to see some more data. I think the media is really picking up on this and turning it into more of a fear story than it is a fact story right now. So let's get some more facts. Let's see what happens. And then maybe take some action.
You pointed out that actually, even though that we ended up with this dismal day and the dismal few days on Wall Street, the stock market did rally today.
It was encouraging to see that in the last hour of trading, we were down over 1,000 points in the Dow, ended up down only 350. I say only 350 because it was really a bad week.
Yeah.
But that is a good sign. Hopefully, we'll get some calmer heads over the weekend, and you'll see some rally and some buying start on Monday morning.
I talked to the Lieutenant Governor today, and he was saying that we can't ignore the fact that Michigan's economy is based so much on the supply chain that comes from across the globe. That is a concern for us here as the coronavirus continues to be a threat.
Yeah, the supply chain, the GDP, what's going to happen with industry, travel as an industry, corporations cutting down on their spending. So all of these things are valid concerns. Do you act on fear or do you act on your knowledge of what is actually fact?
I know you would tell your clients you do not act on fear, and we thank you for sharing that message with us here today. Good to see you, Lyle.
Good to see you, Rob.
All right, we'll check in with you again very, very soon.